Back in mid-2010, a video game researcher by the name of Ian Bogost released a simple Facebook game, actually a satire of social games. In the game, you click on a picture of a cow every 6 hours, and he named it Cow Clicker. Surprisingly enough, the game took off and got legitimately popular. Now, when I was thinking about a project for this course, yes, this one that you're taking right now, I had a realization. Cow Clicker became viral, and cat pictures account for at least a quarter of the internet. In fact, it's widely known that everybody likes cat pictures. So why not combine them, I thought. And so, your first application will be Cat Clicker. Now, your Cat Clicker application should have a picture of a cat and a number that increments when you click the cat. Pretty simple, at least for the first version. You'll get an official spec sheet for the project in a moment. Now, the next several exercises will be based around this Cat Clicker project. Although you could technically get by without actually doing the project, I strongly, strongly urge you to do it. Later in the lesson, you'll learn a scalable approach to building apps. And by building it your default way here and now, you'll get to compare this version of Cat Clicker to the final version once you're done with the course. That final version will be, in a word, awesome. But it's always important to be able to see how far you've come. And besides, for the first iteration of this project, you won't be alone. I'm going to give Andy a call. He's a coworker of mine, and he will be doing this project with you.
Hello?
Hey, how's it going, Andy?
Oh, hey, man.
You taught yourself programming, right?
Yeah, I started working at Udacity a few years ago, and I've actually used our courses to learn how to program.
Makes sense. Would you be willing to build a version of Cat Clicker along with a student here?
Yeah, I could probably build Cat Clicker. I'm not sure how pretty it'll be.
Nah, don't worry about it. That's the whole point. By the end, you'll have a great tool set for working on these apps. Now, Andy will be doing this project with you. You may not feel 100% comfortable in JavaScript right now, and some of this may not still be super easy, but you can do it. Do give this a shot and build it the best way you know how. And after you're done, we'll talk about the next steps. At the end of this self-driven exercise, I'll show you my code, and we can talk about some of the differences.